Henmare! Henmare! BJ wants to cut foreign aid by £4 billion a year, even though he's been warned it could cause tens of thousands of avoidable deaths. Mind you, if there's one thing we know about our BJ is that he's not bothered about preventing tens of thousands of avoidable deaths. He's such a rogue, you know. But some people are saying that our BJ is less of a prime minister and more of a prime monster, and that he's so compassionless about taking human lives that he's like the leader of a death cult. Mind you, when BJ's out and about, I have often heard people shout out to him, "Boris, you cult." I think that's what they're shouting anyway. Look, people have to realise these cuts to foreign aid are necessary because we're in a pandemic. I know we've already spaffed £37 billion during the pandemic on our useless test and trace system, but that's different. That money went to our chums. I mean, £4 billion in foreign aid to save tens of thousands of lives. I mean, what a waste of money, Henry. That money would be much better spent on another loyal yacht and some more tanks that can't shoot whilst they drive and can't drive faster than 20 miles an hour and can only go over obstacles that aren't higher than 8 inches. I know, always money for weapons of war, Henry. Even if they don't work. If they don't work, just chuck hundreds more millions of taxpayers' money at them. No, but you know, this £4 billion of foreign aid could be spent on British people. And by British people, I of course mean our donors and chums. David Davis has said that these cuts to foreign aid are morally devastating. Well, they're not if you don't have any morals to devastate in the first place. Anyway, Henry Mustache, I'll see you at the club later and we'll devastate a bottle or 12 of dry thy thine. Okay, Henry, I'll see you later. Ta-ta, Henry. Ta-ta, 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 ta-ta.